This video is sponsored by ExpressVPN. Keep watching for more information and a special offer. So, yes, I have a new sponsor. And you know me, I would never use my channel to promote something that I couldn't genuinely promote in good faith. And I have turned down a few sponsorship deals in the past. So, what is this service? How is it relevant to this channel? And how can it help you? And yes, this entire video is going to be about this product, but it's definitely going to be of interest to anybody studying German, or for that matter, any other language, as well as expats living in Germany or any other country. So with that in mind, let's press on. Normally, when you connect to a website, there is a direct connection straight to your device. Your device is assigned an IP address, and this IP address tells the website, among other things, which country you're in. This opens up the possibility of geo-blocking. So basically, a website can refuse to serve content to certain locations, and this is where it potentially becomes an issue for you. Suppose you're in, I don't know, America, and you're studying German. You decide to help you, it'd be a good idea to watch some German TV. So you find the websites of some German broadcasters, but all you get is a message telling you that you're not allowed to stream their content. Or maybe you're visiting Germany and you want to watch some programming from your home country. Same problem. And think back just a couple of years to when a dispute over royalties meant that countless thousands of YouTube videos were unavailable in Germany. What you need is a kind of a middleman, a proxy server located in the country whose content you're trying to watch and which can then relay that content to you. The website sees the proxy's IP address and so is perfectly happy to let it have the content. That can be done with a VPN. So if you are, for example, in the US and you want to watch content that can only be streamed in Germany, you use a server that is located inside Germany. The content is streamed to that server and then the server passes it on to you. There are other advantages of using a VPN. For example, they use encryption technology to enhance your security and privacy online, and they make it much harder for third parties to find your IP address and use it to track you down. But for you, perhaps the most important thing is the ability to circumvent geo-blocks. The problem is that the big platforms out there know about VPNs and do all they can to block them. Netflix has been notoriously successful at doing this, and many VPNs appear to have just given up trying. For travelers and language students, this is a sore point. Are you trying to watch your favorite show in a language other than the language of the country you happen to be physically located in at the time? Well, you can't. ExpressVPN, though, hasn't given up. And while you may still have problems from time to time, I have found countless reviews saying that ExpressVPN is the most successful at unblocking Netflix. It's not all plain sailing, because some platforms use more than just your IP address. For example, when I first tried to use ExpressVPN to access the BBC iPlayer, it failed. Apparently, this is because the BBC had previously set a browser cookie telling it that I wasn't actually in the UK. I did then get it to work by first deleting browser cookies and then immediately opening a private browsing window. It seems that the BBC is very clever, so you just have to be a bit more clever. Now, I haven't tested it on a mobile device, but apparently some platforms do look at your phone's GPS coordinates. If you do run into that sort of difficulty, ExpressVPN has 24-hour customer support, or alternatively, a quick Google search is bound to turn up some helpful tips. Connecting to ExpressVPN is very easy. I tried it out on my desktop PC, and all you do is launch the app, choose a location, and connect. Now, all this talk about circumventing geo-blocks might have some of you a bit worried. Is this even legal? Well, I am not a lawyer, but if I thought for one moment there was anything illegal about this product, I would never promote it. There are very few countries in the world where VPNs are illegal. North Korea is one. And if you're watching this from North Korea, then my only question to you is, how? Okay, so using a VPN isn't illegal per se, What about using a VPN to get around a geoblock? Now, here I do have to say that laws may vary from place to place, but in Germany, there is a court ruling on the matter, according to which it is not illegal. There is a law that says you cannot deliberately circumvent copyright protection technology. This law was passed in order to deal with the problem of pirated DVDs. But this law only applies if the technology is implemented by the copyright owner. Geoblocking is implemented by the platform, not the copyright owner. So, good news, Netflix can continue trying to block ExpressVPN, but at least in Germany, can't sue you for using it. Now, there are potential risks involved with using a VPN. They're often advertised as a way to protect your privacy, but there's always a chance that the VPN itself is tracking all of your activities. And if that's the case, then who knows what they might be doing with that information. Now, obviously, the risk is greatest with the cheapest VPNs, and you would be well advised to steer clear of free VPNs. There is a lot you have to take on trust here, and running an efficient and reliable VPN service is not cheap. So if you're not paying for it, who is, and what are they getting in return? Well, when ExpressVPN first got in touch with me, I did a little research and was reassured by what I found. It gets consistently good reviews, and I can't find any evidence of anything shady going on. I mean, okay, I'm not MI5 or the FBI or anyone like that, but nothing I've seen so far has raised any red flags. In 2017, the Turkish authorities seized one of ExpressVPN's servers in the hope of finding logs that it could use as incriminating evidence. It found none, which appears to back up ExpressVPN's claim that it does not record user activity. What else? Well, ExpressVPN is the world's largest premium VPN service and has thousands of servers in 94 countries. And it works on basically any PC, tablet, phone, smart TV, etc., etc., etc. Obviously, it's not free. It works on a subscription model with a 30-day money-back guarantee. You sign up for 1, 6, or 12 months, and at the end of that period, you can, if you want, simply choose not to renew your subscription. But any time during the first 30 days, you can contact support, cancel your subscription, and get your money back. If you use this address or click on the link in the video description, you can sign up for a 12-month plan and get the first 3 months free. That is a 25% discount on your first year for you, my viewers, with a 30-day money-back guarantee. And that's it. Many thanks to ExpressVPN for supporting this channel, and thanks to you for watching this video to the bitter end. You deserve a drink. Or if you don't drink, an ice cream. Or both. Or neither, I don't care.